1941, the war had just begun. The Germans had the biggest ship that had the biggest guns. The Bismarck was the fastest ship that ever sailed the sea. On her decks were guns as big as...
Naam en voorname?
Gzegos Bzentsistikiewicz. Bzentsistikiewicz. Gzegos. Bzentsistikiewicz.
Hello, and welcome back to the second episode of Battleship Bismarck Building. Literally filmed within 30 seconds of the first episode. But, you know, more videos means more adverts, which means more money for me. All 30 pence, which I can't even cash in, I think, until you have, like, 5,000 subscribers. So, like and share, please. I need them bare peas, fam. Anyway, this one comes with screws, so I'm actually going to need a screwdriver kit, which is been sitting here out of shop on my messy desk in a basement in England. It's not the... I think it's probably a feature on an episode of Midsummer Murders. I'm not surprised. Anyway, let's open this up. Obviously we get the second edition of the Battleship Bismarck, which has a nice picture on the front, which really sells it, to be honest. And obviously we get the parts. This is going to be an interesting build for the simple reason it's a gun, and I like guns, as I said. Anyway, so obviously this magazine, so it's the foremost 38cm gun turret. That's quite scary. So this is going to be interesting. So this is the foremost gun, so I assume that's the one, well, the foremost of the ship. That would make sense. This looks very interesting, actually. It doesn't actually allow you to test it, so it's going to be interesting. So if I just put that there, and I try and get into it. I did actually film me trying to get into the other one. However, I looked like I was performing a caesarean on a bit of plastic, and it wasn't very nice to see. So I deleted it, and it will never be seen again. So glad they got there. I'm going to pause this video while I get everything off the sprues, because like I said in the previous episode, I'd rather not get lynched by the modelling community. So, be back in a second. Right, okay, so. Believe it or not, I actually managed to get the bits off the sprues. Right, let's start assembling this. So, the first thing we need to assemble is the armoured hood for the guns. So obviously this is the really, really big bit. Bit that has the big gun things. So I actually absolutely have no idea how these go together, because the angle was a bit odd. But somehow I've got to put these small plastic bits into the bigger plastic bit. So good luck to me, I guess. Probably gonna get this wrong. Doesn't surprise me. So let's put this over here just in case I drop it. But really. Could have got some bigger pliers. Can't see if it goes in here like that. Oh. I want to die. Let's build that a little bit further in, and I'll have to try and find that other piece later. I assume it goes like that. Yes, that looks very nice, doesn't it? Well, I'll tell you what. Oh, fucking hell, I actually found it. Cool, look at that. And on carpet too. Beautiful. I'm like, I've got hawk eyes. In there, boy. Yeah, boy. God, my Bismarck is going to be built on memes and really, really crude comedy. To be honest, that's probably what the original Bismarck was built on. It was a joke.
Yeah, if you can build the biggest ship in the world at the time, circa 1939.
Don't even know if it's the year that she set sail. In all seriousness, warships of that era are very fascinating. Especially when you read up about some of the warships the Japanese came out with. I mean, some of those were stupid. Like, obviously, the Yamato and Musashi. I mean, from a country that basically builds, like, is known for building the smallest things ever, well, they managed to build one of the largest ships in the world. Or largest warships in the world, I should say. It's quite funny, the history of naval combat, how destroyers, which were seen as small and insignificant in regular combat, are now probably the only ships. I think there's one country that still has a cruiser in active duty, or it's ready to be scrapped. I mean, feel free to correct me on that, because I have absolutely no idea what I'm talking about half the time. But, naval history is actually very fascinating. Once you start really getting into it, you start to really understand the mindset of the people that behind the designs of the ships. Like, something I've always wanted was, there's probably a model out there somewhere, and I'll end up getting it at some point, but of the Liberty ships, you know, they were essentially built, to my knowledge, as the... Oh, I'm doing this all wrong. Funny. When you're talking absolute shite and you get things wrong. Anyway, the Liberty ships were built essentially to solve the problem of why do the Nazis keep sinking all of our ships? And the idea was is that you build as many as possible in such a short span of time that it's sure they'll sink them, but it doesn't matter, you've got more on the you can keep pumping them out. I think the companies who built them used to have competitions to see who could build them the fastest. I think one of them ended up being a week or something ridiculous like that, or 5 days, which is absolutely fascinating. And they helped bring supplies to, obviously, Great Britain, and ultimately are responsible for, in my opinion, winning the war, or assisting in winning the war. I think there are a few still around, because the ones that survived ended up just becoming merchant ships, you know, for companies, shipping companies, for the simple reason, I mean, they're there, why not use them? but yeah, it's quite fascinating when you start to get in to naval history. I mean, what was I was reading the other day about the USS Texas, where they actually filled it with water so that during Normandy landings, I think it was the Normandy landings, the ship would fall back on itself and the guns could lift higher, therefore fire further. That's a ship I'd like to see before I die, the USS Texas. She's slowly sinking, which is quite sad. I think she's cared for, but not very well cared for. Right, it's giving me a big red warning. Do not glue any of these next components or we'll kill your family. Lovely.
I'm sorry, Mr. Johnson. Yep. He's a bit on edge. He hasn't slept since 1945.
Ah, right. Okay. And then I'll put this in here. So this is the spring mechanism that will push the guns forward. Forward, in and out, and all that good stuff. So these fall through here like that. Come on. Hello, guns, go through, please. A bit of technical difficulty. The guns won't go through. Ah, there we go. Is it because of... Oh, man, I'm so twat! See, it pays to pay attention, I guess. So, this bit, I actually put around the wrong way. Even, I'm pretty sure people, eagle-eyed people, would have spotted that in the meeting.
Oh, you've got to be shitting me.